Good evening, everyone. Myself, Ashu Sharma. I welcome you all in series of MongoDB. Today, we will see some of the functions like find. We will see the concept of advanced query and the regular expression using that to generate the results from the filtering. So this is the concept which is in the follow-up of that previous videos I have made, that installation of that PyMongo as a driver, which is used for that connectivity between MongoDB database and that Python. And now we will see some of these examples and try to understand what sort of concept behind that. Okay, move to the next slide. Fine, this is the first example that we have. Here we are using find method over here. This is the find method, and we are passing that my query. So we are passing that object, query object, and here we have import PyMongo, and then we are creating this just my client object and having this URL. Here 27017 is a default port number. Except this, there are port numbers like 27018 and 27019 for different purposes for configuration purposes. And now here we have this database. So database is of name my database. And then here is a customers, which is again a collection. So my query, we have this address that we have to find out, and definitely par claim 38. So here what happened that my DOC that to find method is my query. So find method use as that first argument as query object. So this is the query object, my query, which is passing through this find method. So, and finally, there is a for loop that's in my doc. So this is we have. And finally, we print x. So all that string having this address par claim 38 will be generated. When we will run this script, definitely we have this result ID, which is underscore ID, it's the primary key, which is default one, and 11, and then name, when, and address park in 38. Out of that, we have, once we consider that concept of collection. So definitely when we have documents in the collection, then definitely we can go with such kind of examples and try to use that find method. Now move to the next slide. This is that we have second one is using that concept of that modifier. So same approach, we are dealing with that import PyMongo and my client object and having this URL, and then my database and customers as collection. Finally, now address greater than S. So this is that through the modifier, GD is greater than, or definitely we try to find out that results having that letter register sets greater than S or equal to S. So here we have again that for X in my doc. So we are looking for that results from that customer's collections, and finally we print result one by one. So these are the primary default keys, 5, 8, 10, 14. These are the names, Michael, Richard, Vicky, Viola, and finally the address. So you just see that all the letters is either S or greater than S. So this is that way we may use. This is the concept of that advanced query filtering. So it's an advanced query concept. We are using these modifiers, using modifiers. So this is wonderful feature of this, having that, you can say, using find method and using these modifiers to filter the results from documents, which is a store inside that collections. This is very, very important. Now the next is that we have this example of regular expression. Again, we have PyMongo to import, and definitely we have these different URLs that is having this concept, and then address starts with S. So here is, we are using regular expression. So simply we use find method and pass this query object and finally print the result. So those having that is starting with S, address having letter, starting letter is S, having this result is die at this and side way at this. So this is the way you use this find method, having this filter process through that advanced query, through regular expressions, and to find method, you may just limit the search and you see wonderful results over there. So till this lecture, we have seen, if I include previous one, how to install that PyMongo driver and to just execute the different sorts of operations, that how to create that database, how to create collections, and then store, insert documents into it, and having these values along with values. And then finally, today we see, we have seen that, that advanced query options, some modifiers, and regular expressions. So it's a wonderful thing that we just practice this and just revise the concept. It's very, very important. Thank you very much for being with me in this session. If you like these videos, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. So may you may get the notification when I upload new videos. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.